I am the mother of Memet Belialov. Memet has a university education. He finished the Sevastopol National Technical University as a radio engineer. He didn't make it in his first year himself. He enrolled in a preparatory course instead. There were even situations where the dean would call me and I would say, "What happened?" "I don't know, mom." I went to the dean and he says that your son leaves on Fridays and he's not at the university. And I respond, "Didn't he tell you that he reads prayers on Friday? That's why he leaves." "No, he didn't mention it." Then I said, "Well, maybe we can solve this issue somehow." The dean said, "All right." The dean even agreed to let him go, but my son didn't manage to work in his specialty. He finished in 2013. He didn't even manage to get his diploma because due to Russia's arrival in Crimea, there were some problems and it turned out that he had a university education, but not a diploma. He got married. He has a son. He turned 3 on January 16th. When Mehmet was taken, his son was 8 months old. He doesn't remember his dad. We're always telling him about his father, that his father is a good man. He walks up to photographs and says, "Baba, Baba," which means father. He only knows him by photographs. We all live close together. If you take our street, Moiseyeva, then the next street is where the first group of Bakhchisaray guys were taken from. The next street is the second group as well. When Russian security forces were taking our children away, they created a perimeter of 6 streets around. They took everyone. Rather, the riot police encircled everyone, and they didn't let anyone in or out. Somewhere around 6:15 a.m., they came to us and started knocking on the door. They were knocking it very strongly. It was a metal door. Open or else. My husband opened the door and my son, Mehmet, followed along behind him. And they were immediately both forced up against the wall. They made them put their hands up. And then my husband said, "Let me lower my hands, please, because I'm post-surgery." He went for an oncological operation, cancer of the mammary glands, and it was hard for him to stand. And they said, "Doesn't matter, you'll stand for a bit." Of course, later, yes, they let him lower his arms, and they let Mehmet come to them, because the investigator began to read the search warrant. And I immediately said that he wasn't doing anything without a lawyer present, because as they say, the host at home was me. And I said, "What basis do you have? What do you want? What are you looking for?" And the investigator loudly and clearly said, "No, I don't allow any lawyers to come here." Both of my sons actively participated in the organized parties. When the arrests started happening, they helped the families of political prisoners. Someone needed a new lock. They helped someone else install a video doorbell. They helped everyone solve their problems. Whenever anyone needed help, they were always active in that sense. They always helped. There wasn't just the one search at our house. There were two. The second search was at my other son's house. There as well. All because he liked a post with a Muslim symbol. He had to flee in order to avoid arrest.